All right. Welcome to the film room, everybody. We're going to break down some basketball. All these talking heads, these YouTubers, these podcasters. I'm tired of these room temperature IQ takes. Let's talk some real round ball. So, I got the Mavs game pulled up last night, and I was kind of talking about it when I was watching it last night about the really frustrating part about where Dallas lost this game. So first off, I've heard people say they got off to a bad defensive start, which I don't even really like that term or that way of putting it. You know, Dallas, a defense for the most part is what it is. You either have the horses and the guys to do it or you don't. Or you have a good defense or you don't, in a way. Dallas has a good defense. They have a top 10 defense, more than likely, unless things just really change from last year, which I don't see. And I think we got better defensively with the front court additions that we have, especially in the rebounding department. But I've heard people say we got off to a bad start defensively. Yes, New Orleans came out hot. They hit some shots. You know, sometimes that just happens. But also, during that stretch, you know, Dallas, in my opinion, got a lot of hands on balls. They were having a lot of, they got a lot of strips, a lot of pokes. And, you know, there was just a few plays there where it seems like the ball just didn't bounce their way and found its way into a New Orleans Pelicans player's hands. It's not much you can do about that. And over the course of a season, you know, our defense, I think, will rise to the occasion. So I don't really think that that's a very valid talking point. Also considering, I mean, we held the Pelicans to 113 points. Holding an NBA team these days to 113 points isn't necessarily that bad. And, you know, I know the Pelicans had three starters out, but they're also very explosive. Murphy went off. He didn't miss a shot. So, you know, all things considered, I would say our defense was okay. You know, we held them, 40 points in the first quarter. 40 points in the first quarter. They ended up scoring 113. Your defense was pretty solid the rest of the way. And in my opinion, we caused a lot of havoc on the defensive end. Again, we didn't have the ball kind of bounce our way, which, you know, over the course of a season, that will play out. That will be all right. One thing I do want to say, though, is that Luka's going to need to start adopting the Phil Jackson, Kobe Bryant, Michael Jordan mentality. And that is, early in the game, he needs to get other people going. And it goes doubly for Luka this year because he has so many, I think, a lot better role players with Christian Wood, another year with Finney Smith and Reggie Bullock. You know, getting McGee some easy looks, I think, is important. I think he tried to force it a little too much last night. Luka needs to get other people going. There is a difference between getting guys going early and finding out who has the hot hand. I mean, we have several good shooters, decent offensive options. Luka's got plenty of decent options. I'm not going to say we have, you know, Wood is a good scorer. He's going to be good off the bench. Dinwiddie could explode for any night. Bullock, he went like 1 of 6 last night. I don't expect that to continue. Maxey, you know, didn't hit some shots. But the thing is that it is one thing to find your guys early and using that to your advantage the rest of the game. It also makes the defense adapt. So, for instance, if Luka were to try and get Bullock some open looks, or Bullock has some open looks early, and he hits them, now the defense is not 100% focused on Luka. The defense has to respect Bullock, and they have to play a little closer to him, and that could open up things for Dinwiddie, or that could open up things for Finney Smith. That could even open up some more things for Luka. There's a big difference between that and then Luka later in the game getting to take over, when the defense is now having to think about these other players, versus Luka coming out to a hot start, which he does very often, and then trying to find that guy when you find yourself in a struggle late in the third or in the fourth quarter. You know, now you're kind of hoping someone catches fire. You're kind of hoping someone hits some shots or can get their rhythm going, instead of knowing, like, okay, A, we know Luka can always get it going. Anytime he can turn it on, right? He's one of those players. Bullock's hit some threes, let's just say, in this example. Now you have two guys the defense is thinking about in the back of their head, And that is going to make it even easier for guys going forward, or they're going to get some even more open looks. If you've already shown the defense that one or two guys is going to be hitting shots other than Luka. So I want to say that first. Luka needs to learn how to let the game come to him a little more. I love his aggressiveness. I love how he goes to the hole. I love how he likes to bump and get into the paint. And I love his aggressiveness. His shot selection on threes needs to get a little better. He shoots too many, you know, step back, guy in your face kind of threes. I'd like to see him put the ball on the floor or shoot a little bit more of a mid-range instead of so many threes. Get to the line, get other guys' looks with those shots. But I wish Luka would adopt, you know, Phil always said the one thing he told Michael and Kobe is to let the game come to you, get your guys involved. And when it is your time in the second half, could be the third or fourth, but when it's your time in the second half that you can feel it, it's your time to take over, then you take over. You can always turn it on. We know you're that good. You can turn it on when you want. So I will say that. But what I mainly want to talk about in this video is matchups. Basketball is a game of matchups. I'm not saying anything big brain there. But Spencer Dinwiddie in this game, we're going to look at Spencer Dinwiddie versus CJ McCollum and what they did when they got their mismatch. Spencer Dinwiddie, for about 4 or 5, maybe even 6 possessions, we're going to go through it here. They get the switch, they get the big man on Spencer, and there's about 4 or 5 possessions here, clutch key possessions, where he's not aggressive. He doesn't attack the mismatch. If you're going to run the pick and roll, if you're going to get mismatch, if you're going to have the defense switch on you, you have to take advantage, or what's the point? And not only does he not take advantage, but many times he waited way too late to take advantage, or he made a bad decision because he's being pressured instead of just being aggressive and attacking. Spencer Dinwiddie can go off any night, but he has to attack. He has to stop thinking so much. It looks like a lot of times there's a lot of guys on the team, Finney Smith, Dinwiddie, Bullock, even sometimes Green. It just seems like they're thinking too much about the next play, the next dribble, the next series, the next offensive and defensive possession. It seems like only players like Wood and Luka are playing. They are just playing the game. They are just playing in the moment, right? And I would say even McGee is good at that. McGee doesn't really seem, no, I'm not saying he's low IQ basketball, but I'm saying he doesn't seem to think about it very much. McGee knows what he needs to do. He's trying to get to a spot, set good picks, play defense, right? McGee doesn't look like he's overthinking the game when he plays. And so, in my opinion, in this game, Spencer Dinwiddie, as well as Bullock and maybe a few others, it seems like they are thinking too much. Just play. Be aggressive. Shoot or put the ball on the floor or pass it. It's really not that hard in terms of what we need you to do. So let's get into the plays, and we're going to show how, where I think this game was lost. There was some key possessions here where Spencer gets the mismatch. Luka's not on the floor. This is going to be a lineup that we have to push the lead on, or we have to hold our own with Luka not on the floor. And Spencer's going to be a big part of that. And we're going to look at how CJ McCollum attacks his mismatch versus how Spencer Dinwiddie attacked his mismatch, whether it was good or bad. Start of the fourth quarter, Luka's gone out. So here's the first possession. This is just a good example. Spencer Dinwiddie, boom. Ball on the floor, go to the hole. He had the big man on him. It's literally that easy. Sometimes it is that easy. Easy layup. Easy layup. Got the big man on him. There's no way he can guard him.
This didn't come as off.
Called out front as he got to the rim.
Well, this is going to be... And offensive end for the Mavericks. The minutes when Luka Doncic is out.
Campazzo, I think, I'm surprised Campazzo played as many minutes as he did. But Campazzo had a pretty good game. He came in with some good energy.
Carry the weight for this team.
All right, here we go. Spencer's got it.
They have around them. We know they'll be successful with Doncic in again.
13-0 run, bridging the third and fourth quarter. Shot clock is down to 2. Finney Smith peeks at the clock. Campazzo tosses.
See, a good example, Finney Smith. I know Finney Smith is not an offensive-minded guy. He's a 3 and D sort of guy. If he's not wide open for a 3, he does seem a little lost. Finney Smith Look where he gets the ball. Look how open he is, and he decides to pass it.
Shot clock is down to two. Finish.
I am not sure how much of a better shot you can get than just pulling up right here. Do you understand? Like, these guys, some of these guys, in my opinion, they are thinking too much. They don't want to shoot the ball. Maybe Luka, you know, Luka shooting so many shots gets in these guys' heads sometimes. But Finney Smith, I mean, you've got to be aware. 2.4 seconds on the shot clock. Look at where you are. Pull up. Pull up for that. Shoot the little floater. Instead, he leaves Campazzo out to dry. And obviously, he misses the shot. I mean, no one's expecting him to hit that shot.
He did not hit the rim.
We're going to break frequently to you. I do the Dorian finish.
Now, CJ McCollum, it hasn't come up yet, but Maxi's going to get in the game here in a little bit, and CJ is going to get switches on him regularly, and he's going to go after him. And so I just want to keep that in mind. The reason why I bring that up is because I think Maxi's a good defender. I think he's a very underrated defender. He had about four or five. He was responsible for about four or five turnovers on the defensive end. I think Maxi's way underrated as a defender. Yes, he gets dunked on sometimes, but that's because he goes for it. Not a lot of guys are willing to do that. I think he's a smart defender. I think he's one of those guys who's a bend, don't break kind of defender. He's going to stay in front of you. If anything, he's going to make you shoot the jump shot or a tough fadeaway or something like that.
Yeah, it's going to challenge.
The foul was called on Dorian Finney-Smith, and the call will
I have no idea how that was a foul. That might have been the worst call of the game right there. Not being a homer, but good Lord, man. They even challenged that and reviewed it. Look at this.
And the call will stand. Stan Van Gundy gets the W.
I don't understand.
Unsuccessful. The foul was called on Dorian Finney-Smith, and the call will stand.
You know,
Gundy gets the
how do you call that a foul?
To four
anyways,
one on the young
not while we're here.
We know, but on a more serious note, or on the few times they've
all right.
Left him one-on-one.
Here we go. Dinwiddie's got the ball. They're going to come with the pick. They get the mismatch. Immediately decides to do something with it. Even though Wood gets blocked, right? We're talking about getting Wood the ball, you know, essentially underneath the basket. You will live with that. Again, that is a better example of Dinwiddie getting the ball and making a play, making a decision.
New Orleans down by five, pushing the pace.
It's the old saying, you'd rather screw up going 100 miles an hour than screw up going 50 miles an hour, right?
94-91 Mavericks. Still early in the fourth, Luka Doncic.
Look, here we go. Same play. Dinwiddie's going to get the mismatch.
Dinwiddie swing. Wood high arcing three. Bottom. Still early.
So here we go.
Luka Doncic on the bench.
Dinwiddie is going to decide to do something with it.
Dinwiddie swing. Wood high arcing one.
That is all Dinwiddie. I mean, all he does is has to. He makes the threat of the drive. The help comes from the big man. And Wood is wide open, you know?
Wood high arcing three.
So we've seen three plays, right, where Dinwiddie has been aggressive in terms of making a quick decision. Putting the ball on the floor, he got a layup against the mismatch. Whenever he got the pass, they run the pick and roll, immediately passes it. Even though Wood got blocked, I mean, we're talking about Wood rolling to the basket. A defender is having to trail him and chase him. You'll take that situation 9 times out of 10. The defender made a good play. Wood maybe could have pump faked, but you'll take that 9 times out of 10. Wood going to the basket, getting in the lane 5 feet away. You can't ask for much better than that. The next time down, Dinwiddie puts it on the floor. He's already shown he can get to the basket. Big man takes one or two steps over to help because he's worried about it. Wood's left wide open for a three.
Bottom.
Three good examples, right? Three good examples of Dinwiddie attacking. He got a mismatch, a pick and roll, and then he made a good pass.
A dual threat pick and roll guy, much like the Mavericks had when they had Porzingis. Wood off to
Valanciunas will shoot. Dish it, NBAball.com. Toronto.
And now be a rebounder.
97-93.
As we saw,
all right, here we go.
Recovery earlier to get the block on Christian Wood.
Dinwiddie brings it up. They're going to run the exact same play. They're going to want to pick and roll. Look, he's got the mismatch. All right. This is what I mean. I want people to keep this in mind that they're going to run this play a few more times where they get the big man on Dinwiddie. And we're going to see the contrast between what Dinwiddie does here going forward and what CJ McCollum's going to do here in a little bit on Maxi whenever they get the switch on Maxi.
Mavericks. Dinwiddie
waiting.
Yep.
See, here comes the double. Still doesn't get rid of it. What is that? What is that? What is going on? Like, I don't understand how you go three straight plays being aggressive, making quick decisions, and they all turned out good, even though Wood got blocked on one. Wood hit a three on the other, and you got an easy layup on the first. And this just makes, this is just, as someone who, again, I love basketball. I'm not saying I have a 9,000 IQ in basketball, but I just do not understand this play.
Career, 97-93.
Eight, backs it out. Okay, if you're going to back it out to kind of give you a second to let the defender, that second defender, clear out, okay, that's one thing. But he does it. Mavericks. He holds it for so long.
Dinwiddie directing.
Here comes the double. Why is the double coming? Even the defense knows Dinwiddie is going to cook this guy if he's left alone, right? So the double comes.
Traffic would not.
Why isn't the easy pass made to Wood right here? This just makes no sense to me. I don't understand. Wood has been, and this is also about knowing your players and who you're playing with, Wood has been on fire. The guy should be getting the rock anytime he's open right now. And this is, oh, you know, the saying, make the easy pass. Look at this pass. Look how, I mean, I don't understand how, with 9 seconds to go in the shot clock, I don't understand, unless there is some play that they're trying to run or some look that they think is going to be there, it makes no sense to me why you can't simply just kick the ball over to Wood. This is one of those things where he is thinking too much about it. Just give Wood the ball right there out of the double team. And you still have 9 seconds to work with.
To shoot. They bring a double.
And this pass right here, if you made this pass in junior high and high school, you'd find a spot real quick next to me on the bench. That's what I would think. I just can't understand it.
High pass. And it's
really frustrating to watch. If anyone who knows basketball, it's just so frustrating to watch.
Taking it in.
But I like what New Orleans did there. Instead of letting
nails the triple,
which the initial.
Let's see. Maxie's not in yet.
Did not allow Valanciunas to get isolated. They came
and reason why I'm not bringing up CJ quite yet is because even though they're doing the pick and roll and CJ is getting switches right here, they're not necessarily big mismatches, right? If he's got Dinwiddie on him, even Christian Wood a little bit, I wouldn't call that like a massive mismatch, right? Now, when Maxi gets in here in a little bit, having Maxi guard McCollum on the wing, that's a big mismatch. And Wood guarding CJ is probably a pretty decent mismatch as well. Although I would say Wood's probably a little longer, probably moves maybe slightly better than Maxi. But both of those guys are still sort of a mismatch issue if they're having to guard McCollum on the wing, who's one of the better scorers. But we're going to see when Maxi gets in here in a little bit the difference.
McCollum nails the triple.
Here we go.
96, Dallas with
Dinwiddie's going to get the ball. We're going to run the exact same play.
Turnovers. We're at the 8:37 mark. And
what are we doing? What are we doing?
Kleba will pop off.
He calls for the ISO. You see him wave him away. He calls for the ISO.
The
and then, you know, this is like situational awareness. You have a big ugly on you. You have some big ugly slow guy on you for Dinwiddie standards. And you kick it over to Campazzo, the guy who joined your team yesterday. And this is his first game. And although he played decent in this game, there is no reason for Dinwiddie to give the ball up in this situation right here.
Dallas with four.
Again, if you're going to run this to get the mismatch,
turnovers.
Attack it. Don't give it up.
Mark, and Kleba will pop off the bench.
The double team never comes. No one is coming to pressure Dinwiddie. He is one-on-one ISO. With 9 seconds to go, simply moving the ball from here to here does nothing. Again, maybe they're trying. It looks like they're trying to get Wood on the block, right? But again, Campazzo doesn't swing it immediately to Green in the corner, which is what you would do if you're trying to get it to Wood on the block. So I got to think that the play was the pick and roll. I mean, that's what I would think, right? Perhaps the play is to try and get it to Wood here on the block. But again, Campazzo doesn't swing it. They don't try to work it in, right? If that was the play, 8 seconds to go, you would think you would probably try to work it in, but they don't.
A zone look here. Campazzo trying to find an opening. Tosses it up. Air ball.
And look, while that's a bad shot on Campazzo, you know, yes, it's a bad shot, right? But like, as a coach or as a team, you have to realize, like, you just left Campazzo, who's not a one-on-one player. He's not going to blow anyone away. He's not some 6'4", you know, 35-inch vertical guard who can hit threes, you know, on a whim or something, or take it to the hole. To leave a guy like that out on the wing with 8 seconds to go, that's just horrible offense. Again, what are we doing? What is the play? There is no reason why Dinwiddie should be giving the ball up to Campazzo for an ISO. I don't. It makes zero sense. Dinwiddie when they ran the switch and Dinwiddie just got it, I'll take that ISO all day. Dinwiddie's been on fire. Dinwiddie can score in bunches with the best of them. Dinwiddie is just fine if he's aggressive, takes his shot, or puts it on the floor. But for whatever reason, he gets the mismatch right here. He's got the big ugly on him, and instead of breaking him down for a play or trying to make something happen, being aggressive, making a decision, he swings it over to Campazzo. It's just, again, I can't get in the head of Jason Kidd. Maybe there's a different play they're trying to run. It makes no sense to me. You know, again, I don't really blame Campazzo for that, if that makes sense.
And McCollum knocks it down. CJ McCollum's not gonna
All right, Maxey's in the game. Let's see what McCollum does on the switch, right? Let's see what McCollum does.
He knows it's winning time in the fourth quarter.
For the lead, McCollum!
You know, again, that's a semi-difficult shot. Maxey's kind of hand somewhat in the vicinity, right? But again, he's just a step back three. Maxey can't keep up. All right. Okay. Again, we come down. What are we going to do? We want to get Spencey the mismatch. And what does Spencey do? So I guess the play here is to try and get it to Wood. Wasn't there.
And fuel this 11-3 run. And a whistle.
Again, I like Maxey's game, right? For a power forward, he might be one of the better 3-and-D guys in the league. Him posting up high block, high post like that, not a big fan of. I'm not a big fan of, again, Spencer giving it up to Finney-Smith. Finney-Smith is a set shooter. You know, he's going to have to set up in a spot and shoot a three. We saw earlier he goes to the hole. He's not quite that sure in his game yet to shoot a little pull-up or a floater or something, even though he was, you know, 12, 13 feet out, essentially wide open. So getting the ball to Finney-Smith, you know, I'm just not sure of. And again, look, who is the guy you'd rather give the ball to in a high post or an extended post area? Christian Wood or Maxey Kleba, right? Someone answer me that. I'm pretty sure the answer is very obvious, especially given how good Wood has been playing. Why are you not giving this man the ball? I don't understand it. You know, I call him big uglies, but if the big uglies scoring, the big uglies making shots, I'll feed the big man all day. I don't understand what we're doing here. Now, yes, Maxey is semi-open here, right? But again, McCollum's already rotating over. Maxey is not a put-it-on-the-floor kind of guy. Either he's going to shoot the shot or he's got to pass it, right? Now instead of Christian Wood and Spencer Dinwiddie running a pick-and-roll or getting it to Wood on the extended block, we're running a pick and roll with Campazzo and Maxey. Do you understand here? Like it's just frustrating to watch what was working, which was very easy. It's very easy. Spencer, Christian Wood, pick and roll. I don't understand why they went away from it. Why it worked like three times in a row, and then all of a sudden, again, it's like everyone started thinking too much. Everyone starts going like, well, we got to move it around. We got to get other guys involved. No, If you have a mismatch, you attack it every single time. If you think you have a favorable mismatch, you make them prove to you that they can stop you. New Orleans didn't prove that they could stop Dinwiddie tonight. Dinwiddie beat himself in these possessions. I don't understand. Again, to me, it's just overthinking it, right? I got to get Campazzo involved. I got to get Maxey involved. No, you attack a weakness until they make you do something else. And I feel like we left what was working instead of, as the saying goes, milking the hot hand or milking the play that's working. You know, Christian Wood, Spencer Dinwiddie, pick and roll for a bench combination coming off the bench. Spencer and Christian Wood pick and roll is about as nice as it gets for two guys off the bench.
Fuel this 11-3 run. And in the period, foul on Graham against Cleveland.
Gonna run it again.
98-97, New Orleans. Dinwiddie lets it fly. Book it.
Do you see what I'm saying? I mean, it's like, it was so frustrating watching this last night. Every time Spencer decided, you know, Spencer and Christian, when they're on the bench or coming off the bench and they come in, these two guys need to be looking to score 20 points each a night. I mean, that should be their mentality. I'm not saying they have to force it or anything, but it's just, you know, it's literally that easy. You know, I don't understand. It seems like to me they're overcomplicating it in their heads. They're thinking too much about it. And here we go. Spencer, switch, big man, make a move. He takes a step back, pull the three and hit it. That easy. So we've seen about 6 or 7 possessions now, on 4 of them, of which Spencer has been aggressive, looked to make a play, looked to take his shot. It's been good. The only bad play out of those 4 was, again, Wood getting wide open, rolling to the basket, and the defender made a good recovery play and blocked it. Again, we'll take that 9 times out of 10. If you were to run that exact same play again and Christian Wood got open, the next time he's going to pump fake him and go to the line. Or get a bucket or something. You know, Christian Wood will make the right play the next time when he's got the defender beat.
Nance played it.
All right, McCollum, we're gonna see. Exactly, it's day and night. You got to switch here. Didn't get what we want. Switch it again.
He's 4 of 6 from downtown. 22 points. The roll.
See?
Graham. Yes.
Not quite as smooth an offensive play that time, but again, CJ still attacks. By attacking a mismatch, you have the opportunity to do one of several things.
A reliable three.
And look at this. Because Maxey cannot keep up with CJ. Again, Maxey's a good defender. He's not going to keep up with one of the more premier guards on the perimeter, though. Because Maxey hasn't recovered yet, Bullock has to come over. Finney Smith is trying to recover still. Look at that. 3 guys on 1. Just because McCollum is simply at least giving the impression he's going to attack.
Shooter.
He's 4 of 6 from downtown. 22 points.
And again, it's causing confusion for the Mavericks. They're having to recover. They're on their back foot trying to chase McCollum around.
A reliable 3-point shooter.
He's 4 of 6 from downtown.
I mean, just like that, right? It's just frustrating because it's not really that difficult. You get it here. It's just like breaking a press, right? You get the ball in the middle of the court on a press, the press is dead. You get the ball in the middle of a lane, especially like this, wide open. I mean, you're in a world of hurt in terms of a defense. You got a guy wide open. This guy could still shoot a little floater in the lane. He could kick it out. If he kicks it here, a guy's got to rotate. He's coming late.
It's the roll.
Now, theoretically, this is on Finney Smith, right? Bullock knows this guy's here. Finney Smith's got to know this guy's here. He's just a step late, you know, which is a good play by New Orleans. That's just a tough one. But again, McCollum attacking is what makes it happen. So we're going to do the same thing again. We're going to get the mismatch. What are we doing? What is this? As soon as you get the big man on you, you kick it over to Finney Smith in the corner with the defender all over him. Why? I don't understand. And I guess they're trying to get Wood the ball here, but the problem is that when Finney Smith gets the ball, again, Finney Smith is not a put it on the floor kind of guy yet. I think he's slowly coming around on his offensive game. Finney Smith is an open three shooter. That's what he is right now on the offensive end. So they're going to deny Wood. Again, they're denying Wood, and they're bringing a double team to Spencer. You see 22 over here is all the way up on Spencer. They're not going to let Dinwiddie get the ball again. They're fronting Wood in the post. Essentially, again, they're saying Bullock or Maxey is going to have to beat us.
We hit the 7-minute mark, fourth quarter. Bullock, open look, side rim.
Not a bad offensive position considering it was stuck in the corner with Finney Smith. And you hope, again, I think Bullock went 1 of 6, 1 of 7, something like that from the three. You have to think in another world he hits a couple of these threes. So, you know, I heard a lot of people giving Bullock some flack. Yes, would have been nice if he hit a few more shots, but he'll come around. You give him open looks like that, I'll live with that. And a really stupid foul. Even though it wasn't much of a foul, you just can't do that.
And knocks it in. His third three of the night, and he's
Orleans 46% from three-point territory. Dallas 36% beyond the arc. Luka Doncic back in the game with 6.
So here we go.
To go in regulation.
They're
going to
get Maxey on CJ, and let's see how CJ attacks. Do you understand?
Shooting some more threes. Already 23 attempts.
It's that easy. You attack your mismatch. You make the defense have to do something else.
That's 11 made threes on the
So even though Luka's in the game, Spencer immediately puts it on the floor.
Last in the league in attempts.
Although Bullock missed that, you know, he got a wide open three. And again, because Spencer put it on the floor, the defense had to collapse.
Last in the league in attempts.
That's kind of a weak call in my opinion, but that's okay. Again, Spencer off the dribble is really tough. When he puts it on the floor, he kind of reminds me of Stackhouse a little bit. When he puts it on the floor and he's made up his mind, he's going to go to the hole. And he's really hard to stop. And again, you look at him drive and look how wide open Bullock is. Even before the foul, right? And they call Maxey here for a little bit of a moving screen. Okay.
Last in the league in attempts, and McCollum takes a charge.
So look, they get the mismatch again. And you see, McCollum has no second thoughts about what he's going to do, right? This is where I mean Spencer, for a few possessions there, seemed like he was thinking way too hard. He's overthinking it, thinking he's got to get guys involved, spread it around. McCollum's getting this mismatch, and he's saying, I'm taking this until someone stops me.
McCollum, kick, Graham, jumper.
Now again, why the offensive foul on the other end, and there's not one on this end, but that's okay.
Rebound, put back, Murphy slips inside for two. .106-100, just past the midway point of the fourth.
Now I got the mismatch. That's good. Wood also, because they have to switch, Wood also has a mismatch, so we get it to Wood, so that's acceptable.
Wood, swing, Bullock, jab step and a J, short.
Again, you gotta hope Bullock, through, you know, as the time goes on throughout the season, Bullock's gonna hit more of these.
Rebound tracked down by Nance. It's an extended 15-3 run.
Already got the switch. McCollum has no doubts about passing it or anything. He's going to attack this all day.
McCollum. The drive. Off the rim. Out of bounds.
That was a good D by Maxey. I mean, even he still almost made it. It wasn't a horrible shot.
There by Najee Marshall on the boards. Win or lose tonight, what we've seen. Formidable rosters in the league.
Here we go. We're going to run it one more time.
New Orleans 106, Dallas 100. We approach.
You see, do you see the difference in body language between Spencer and CJ? CJ, although that last play, like, he backed it out, there was never any doubt about what CJ was going to do. CJ was going to attack Maxey. Every single time he's done it, he's going to attack Maxey. Here, Spencer's looking around. He wants to get it to somebody. He wants to spread it around. CJ, when he had it, was looking at Maxey the whole time, was looking at the rim. That's what he had on his mind. If he has to dish it when he drives, that's another thing. But there was never a doubt what CJ was going to do. Here, Spencer, he's hesitating. It's like, I understand they maybe want to try and get it into the post. But at the same time, Spencer, every time you are aggressive on a big man like this, something good has happened. And that's what's so frustrating is that, you know, when you're playing, right, like, if you got a smaller guard on you, guarding you, right, and you're a guard too, and you're able to just get an ISO in the post over and over and over and beat him, why shoot threes, you know? Why shoot threes if that's what they're going to give you and if it's working? Or if you're a guard and you have a kind of a bigger guy on you who can't cover you, and so you're running around getting wide open looks in the three, why try to post him up? You understand, like, it sometimes it's really not that difficult. The game's not that complex. Sometimes it's as easy as apple pie. Pardon the stupid pun.
5 minutes to go.
But look, they're gonna front Wood. They're not gonna let Wood get the ball in the post. They've already made that decision. Someone else is gonna have to step up. Someone else has to do something to get something going. And instead of Spencer saying he is, I know Luka's on the floor right now, but you know, earlier Spencer and Wood are it in terms of offensive playmaking for coming off the bench when Luka's not on the floor, right? They have got to understand that. And I think Spencer wants to play point guard a little too much. We need you to play two guard. We need you to play score guard, or we need you to play scoring. That's what we need you to do. We need you to score. That's why you're here.
Go fourth quarter. Dinwiddie with five to shoot.
Now, Spencer makes this, right? But I want us to go back.
New Orleans.
11 seconds on the shot clock, correct? And this is what I mean by being aggressive, too. Because you can be aggressive and maybe mess up or miss the shot, or maybe you kick it out, and you can still get another revolution of an offensive play call in or another offensive set. Instead, Spencer's going to get this switch with 12 or 11 seconds, and he's going to hold it, and he's going to hold it, and he's going
to
hold it, and he's going
to,
now he's thinking about scoring. Do you understand? We just wasted 5 seconds, which it doesn't seem like a lot, 4 or 5 seconds. It doesn't seem like a lot, but, you know, you need to be aggressive, and now is where you're putting your back against the wall, right? You need to be putting the defense on the back foot. Instead, now you're going to have to kind of force something. And although he makes this shot here, it still is not, in my opinion, the right way of attacking a mismatch or when you get a switch like this.
Dinwiddie with five to shoot.
4 seconds to go, and now he's going to go.
One-on-one with Nance. Dinwiddie got him.
Again, I mean, this shows you how good Spencer is when he decides to make a play, when he decides to be aggressive. Stop thinking and go.
A great drive, but to deny him the ball, he's going to have to work without the ball. Doncic isn't getting the ball, Ian, and part of that's on Doncic. Najee Marshall really working to deny him the ball. He's going to have to work without the ball to get the
ball. I like this play here. They get the switch by actually getting the big man the ball and having CJ come over. Again,
is down to six. Graham. Oh yeah.
And what's a little frustrating about this is that Dallas, understanding that Maxey needs help, sends the double, right? And remember when they went to go double Spencer, right? All Spencer had to do was make that easy pass to Christian Wood at the top of the three-point line, a little bit to the left. And so
Luka Doncic,
we see here CJ gets the ball.
24 for Spencer Dinwiddie.
Double comes. Now, what Spencer did on his turn is he tried to throw it in the corner here to number 8. That's what Spencer tried to do, remember? He tried to throw a cross-court pass, essentially, from way further away than what CJ is right now. He tried to thread the needle all the way to the corner over here, and it was a turnover. It was a really hard pass for Finney Smith to catch. And what does CJ do? The easy pass. There's no need to force it. All Spencer had to do on that one play where he tried to lob it all the way over to Finney Smith was just make the easy pass to Christian Wood.
Is down to six.
It's that's what I mean. They're overthinking it. It's that
Graham.
Simple.
Oh, yeah.
And to me, what we saw here, that was the game. I mean, at this point here, although the Mavs make a little bit of a spurt here, that was the game right there, those series. And in my opinion, all it took was Spencer being a little more aggressive.
Kleba flies in. Doncic drive and kick, two-man game. Kleba on target.
See, that's what Finney Smith, Bullock, and Maxey are right there. They are spot-up three shooters, right? They have got to be open for them to make a shot or make a play, more than likely. I'm not saying that if they're – obviously, if they have a wide-open lane to the basket, they pump fake somebody or something, obviously they can do something with it. But they are not a break-a-defender-down-off-the-dribble kind of guys. If you're asking them to do that, your offense is in a world of hurt.
And that's why you stepped up in the third
So same play. They're going to try to run CJ over on the switch. It's not there. So they'll do it with the other guard.
Nance, kick, Marshall, off the rim. And
wide open look.
Go without Valanciunas.
So look, they go to double Luka. Spencer's going to get the ball. He's going to get a big ugly on him again. He needs to attack him.
Get a more mobile defender.
And this is when you look at this right here, right? Look at this right here. This guy is all over Luka. They are doing everything they can to deny Luka the ball. Luka has a decent defender on him. Spencer has this big ugly on him. And I don't know. I don't understand. I understand you want to get Luka the ball. There's, you know, a little over 3 minutes. You're down by four. I understand that. But again, there's 6 seconds on the shot clock. And Spencer, again, you have a mismatch, right? You have, like, basketball's all about matchups. I said it earlier, and everyone's heard it 1,000 times if you watch any basketball. You get a mismatch in a matchup that you want, and you don't exploit it. You know, so what are we doing here? And to me, this is one of those things where they're overthinking it. Spencer just should have put the ball on the floor and attacked, or done something off the dribble.
In the game, in Nance.
So now here we are with, you know, under 4 seconds to go now, and Luka's going to have
Doncic
to put up a tough shot.
The jumper is short. Tracked down by Bullock. Dinwiddie. Oh, that's really deep.
I didn't like that shot either.
No, but a foul. Kleba is going to the free throw. Now for Dallas, 107. No changes for New Orleans. Valanciunas remains on the bench.
That switch right there with Finney Smith and Bullock, I absolutely love, man. That's got to be one of the best defensive switches in the league. I just absolutely love. There is nothing more frustrating as like an offense trying to run an offensive play or get a mismatch, and every guy you just run into is like the same 6'6", 6'8", long wingspan, athletic guy, right? There are no mismatches, right? And I love Bullock. When I see Bullock and Finney Smith, I think about that. It's like, okay, I got Bullock off me. Well, shit, now I have Finney Smith on me. Not much better. You're in the same boat. So, again, defensively, I think we're going to be just fine in the long run.
And that ball is out.
Another turnover caused by Maxey. Maxey got a lot of hands-on balls this game. He had about, I think he caused about 4 or 5 turnovers. So, as much as CJ cooks him here in this fourth quarter, he makes up for it a little bit. His off-ball defense was very nice.
No Christian Wood here going with their defensive lineup. CJ McCollum here. Not only getting it done.
Yeah, CJ's really turned into a nice player.
Dinwiddie missing from 3-point territory. Stan, we had
again, that was a tough shot. A shot selection is one thing I could talk about all day. Which I mean, largely we've talked about shot selection here, but more importantly about mismatches. Again, run the same play, bring the big man over. I mean,
2:24 to play, fourth quarter.
I guarantee.
It's also frustrating because even though they're kind of doing it different ways, New Orleans is putting the ball in the hands of the big man and then running CJ over to him to get the switch, and Dallas is running more of like more of a classic pick and roll to get the switch. It still is the same logic. It's still the same sort of exploitation on the mismatch. And this is a nice play here, right? Again, they know CJ coming across. Again, I think Luka's defense has improved a little bit this year, but still, Luka having to guard CJ out on the wing is a mismatch. So, Bullock has to respect CJ to some degree, and it's a nice slip by the big man.
Both coaches spent all their time on defense. What a feed, McCollum. And assists for C.J. McCollum.
They're going to load up on Doncic. There's a double team.
Swing it. Bullock, the floater. He pulled the string on it. Bucks out by Nance.
That's not Bullock's game.
Yeah, Bullock's exactly.
A three-point shooter and a ball mover and a defender. He is not a guy shooting runners. That's not going to be successful. Good defense by the Pelicans getting the ball.
They're
going to
get Maxey on a switch here again. Attack. Attack. See? Good things happen when you attack. And the thing is, if you attack right and you attack quick, you can get another offensive revolution in.
Here's C.J. McCollum.
State Farm, Philadelphia, New Orleans, Atlanta, the Clippers, Orlando. Coach of the Pelicans, sharp, 2 to play. Doncic against Nance. Doncic.
This is also what I was talking about. Luka, again, it's because now, besides Wood and Dinwiddie, you know, there's really no one else that we're sure can hit a shot right now. You know, maybe Maxey hit one, but he only took like two or three shots. Wood's not on the floor. Dinwiddie is open here in the corner. Again, he's missed his last two threes, though. Finney Smith's open in the other corner. He hadn't done much. And so now Luka feels like he has to force it, right? No one is the defense is not respecting anyone else. Anyone else. Because why should they? You know, again, had Luka come out early and got people involved and they had a hot hand, they had a stroke going, they were shooting a good clip because because people are having to collapse in on Luka or pay attention to him, it's a whole different realm or it's a whole different situation. If Luka and the defense feel like Luka could easily dump it off to any one of these guys, or there's two guys that have been hot tonight that we have to respect. Now New Orleans is saying, I dare you to give it to one of these other guys and hit a shot. I dare you.
Is fouled. So Dallas with 9 seconds to work with. Nance draws the assignment. Doncic, short, rebounded by Wood. Swing it for Bullock. We're down to 1:04 to go. Dinwiddie. Dallas taking a lot of time. Dinwiddie the drive. Dish Finney. Smith hangs. He missed it. Rebound. Foot four. Poked out of bounds.
Tough one.
Yeah, that should have been Dallas's ball. I do remember that. But again, he drove. Finney Smith was somewhat open, you know. Not a horrible shot.
For New Orleans. Graham. Jumper. Missed it long. And the rebound knocked out of bounds by Nance. Back to New Orleans. Two, neither team.
Don't have to foul at the other end.
Doncic against Nance. The spin, the fake, the bucket for Luka.
See,
Doncic.
You know, and although, you know, Luka, his shot selection on threes was pretty bad tonight, or at least he didn't hit them. Again, he's aggressive. So many good things happen just because he's aggressive, right? Again, he beats the bigger man off the dribble, off the spin move, gets the up and under.
Cuts it to three.
There's no reason why Spencer couldn't have done that.
And now, with a 6-second differential, Dallas can just play for the stop here.
Graham hands to McCollum. 10 to shoot.
McCollum, and so you see they had to pull Maxey. He's no longer on the floor. So
McCollum off the heel, rebounded by Bullock. Dallas with possession. Down by three.
And then just a tough shot. Well, I mean, he makes this.
Layup goes.
I think Luka was really trying for the and one there. He just didn't get it. But obviously Luka comes down. He misses that three. So just thought I'd break it down. I love breaking down basketball game film. But I really thought Spencer hesitating on those possessions, not attacking the mismatch and the weakness when he'd already shown it worked. I mean, they got so many good looks. They got good possessions out of when Spencer attacked or made a quick decision. And I really feel like those possessions there, Dallas shot themselves in the foot. Spencer, you know, there's a few plays he just could have made the easy pass. He should have taken the guy off the dribble. He waited too long. He had to force it, or he made a pass to the wrong guy at the wrong time. You know, Campazzo with a second to go, he's got to jack it up. And so I just wanted to break that down. That right there, that kind of was maybe about 8-minute stretch there or something. That was the game right there. And all Dallas needed was one or two more good possessions. And I really feel like Spencer got in his own head a little bit. I really don't know how else to put it, but I feel like he started overthinking it. I feel like he started wanting to make sure guys were getting touches, and you know, he had already scored a lot. I don't know. I can't get in his head, but Spencer just should have been aggressive, and I think good things would have happened, as he had already shown. So that's the first installment of the film room. I'll do this some more. I love breaking down basketball.